show you quickly. I know that a few people wanted to know volume attachment. Now, because it is part of my course and because I can't really film doing a live video and showing you how to do different attachment methods, I will draw this on for you. Okay, let me get rid of this bit. I just got to find my pens. Where did I put them? Hang on. Awesome. Now, I can't actually see you at the moment, so I will read the comments after. I hope you can kind of see. I will go back and forth and have a look. Actually, let me move this out a bit more. There. That should suffice. Awesome. So different volume attachments, very, very important. I will show you the ones that you should not be doing, and then I'll show you the ones that you should be doing. Now let's assume this one here is our natural lash. Yes, let me check where that is in the picture. Okay, I move this over a bit. Great. So this is our natural lash, and now let's work with a 5D fan, okay? So, something that I see a lot of people do all the time, which is not correct, is to attach it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like straight, okay? This is the straight attachment, is also called T-bar. And this is incorrect because, you know, you have lots of space in between, it doesn't grab properly, there's not enough attachment area, okay? This is number one. Can you all see this properly? Yes, I can put one next to it. Then we have another one that a lot of people do. Let's work with 5 again, which is, let's say we're attaching from the side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, which is kind of, you know, it could also be on top or this side or from the bottom. It doesn't matter. This is called bunched up because we're kind of layering the different lashes within the fan on top of each other and having more of a thicker kind of attachment area, yeah? It's not as bad as this, but it's not considered the best sort of competition work. However, for my beginners, I always say aim for this if you can't achieve a proper rep or side attachment, which I will share with you later. But so this is probably the most commonly used by a lot of beginners if you haven't learned how to wrap properly yet. And so this is called bunched up. Bunched up. And let me see where that is in the video so we have more room. No, I'll get rid of it. If I can find my tissue. Now the next attachment, which is actually find one of the worst, is if you have a split fan. Oh, maybe I should have put that lower. Hang on. Put it there. This is the natural lash again. So what a split fan is basically you have some of the lashes are attached and then some are kind of not even attached whatsoever. Yeah? Now this area will collect a lot of dust, dirt, grime, debris, yuckiness, neighboring lashes, and they will start pulling on each other. And yeah, if this one is really close to the client's skin, let's say here's the skin of the eye, this can actually poke the client in the eye and the skin all the time, which is, you know, not really kind of what we want to do. And so this is a split fan attachment, so don't do this. If you see this happening, if you're working on a client, remove the fan straight away. Sometimes you can hold the fan at the top. Like let's say this is your nice applied fan here and then this one kind of sticks out. So you can hold this with your tweezers and then pull this one off. Yeah, sometimes that works. But if it doesn't, remove it all. Okay. Then we have our wrap. Wrap. Oh, can you see this up there? Yep. Great. We have our wrapping method, and a wrapping method only really starts to happen from about 4D, yeah? Let's say you only have 3 lashes, a 3D lash, a fan. It doesn't really wrap all the way around, right? So once you start having four, it kind of looks more like a wrap or like this, yeah? So depending on how the thickness of your natural lash and the actual extension you're gonna put on. So let's say you're having much, much thicker lashes within the fan, it will start wrapping around at about four, much more, yeah? Let's say we have five again. So this is what's called a wrap. The natural lash is kind of hugged by those four lashes, yeah? This is what we consider the perfect norm. I find it quite annoying at times to remove. It looks the nicest, yes, but in an everyday situation, working on clients every day, knowing that we're working by time, I actually find this, you know, really annoying. Unless you're doing competition work, I don't actually aim for this every single time. If it doesn't happen, I'm not going to kill myself because I know that an attachment that is a little bit bunched, like this, for example, let's say you have like a 70 fan or something like that, it is a little bit bunched. Your client won't notice a difference. If you are in a competition, don't do this. If you do photographic work, don't do this. On an everyday client, however, if it happens, it's fine. Your client is not going to notice, and it will actually last okay as well. These ones last a very long time because they literally wrap around the natural lash, like it kind of gets sucked inside, like this almost. However, they are very, very hard to remove, and sometimes you have to banana peel a lot. So those are the main type of wrapping or attachment methods.